Hello, everybody. You're here with Claru Beauty with Claudia Lara. Thank you very much for tuning in. Today, you know how much I don't like greeting you with a completely bare face. But today, we're going to do some foundation. So, what can I tell you? So, welcome in. I want to try today, I have this sample. It is Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. This is what we're gonna be trying today. And then I'm gonna continue with some Charlotte Tilbury look. I wanna specifically try a gray sort of eyes. And so we're gonna be doing the Charlotte Tilbury, the Rock Chick, with is Liquid Liner Panther, and well, some goodies from Charlotte Tilbury, but I really wanted to try this Giorgio Armani. So let's see what happens. Now, what do I know about this liquid foundation? Well, not much as usual. But my experience with this has been, I have dry skin, and my sister, which is much younger than me, she has dry skin as well, but she has more prone to acne. And so I hope she doesn't mind me saying that. She has clean face right now. You can check her Instagram. Actually, she's gorgeous. And I'm going a little to the side, but this is, I think it's gonna be good. You'll enjoy it because she's not only beautiful, but she posts about traveling, trips, food, and then of course her beauty. So I really recommend you to check out her Instagram. I'm gonna post it below. I don't know it by heart, apologize. And so check it out. Anyhow, for her, this foundation works wonderful. It looks amazing. Another interruption. I don't know if you can hear all my dogs howling. That's because they miss me. Because usually at this time when I'm filming, I'm playing with them. I already play with them, don't worry. I woke up very early and play with them. But so that's their way of calling me over. So I'm gonna go there in a little bit. This is gonna be a quick one, don't worry. So anyway, where were I? Where was I? So this foundation on my sister works beautiful. It just works. It just looks amazing on her. This on me, we're gonna check it out now. I haven't tried it in a while, but it was not my best experience. So I wouldn't say it's for everybody with dry skin. So there you have it. I mean, what's the difference? I'm not sure. I'm not prone to acne, but I am prone to redness and sensitive skin. And so my skin will look drier much faster with products than with hers. And a lot of products, when they're supposed to moisturize, they look like I have it on top of my face. You know, like I have a layer on top, so it's very noticeable that I'm wearing makeup. So I don't remember that was the case. Let's check it out. Let's start with this one. But I think it had dry patches on me. I think that's what happened. So let's try it out. I'm going to... This is on color 2. And I'm not sure if this is exactly my color. This might be a little lighter, but we'll see the consistency. We'll see how it lays. We'll see how it works. Yes, I look like a clown at this moment. Not my favorite thing on camera, but hey. All right, let's, no judgment, right? No judgment. All right, so far, I love how it's coming, being on. I mean, apply, look how easy. And of course, I'm using my IHT dual brush, which I talk about in most of my videos because I love it. I actually have 3 of these brushes. Why? Because I keep one in my bathroom where I keep most of my foundations. Then I keep one here. to film with you all. And then I have another one which I use to apply bronzer. If you have seen my videos, you'll know what I'm talking about. All right, so how is it looking so far? Huh? You'll be the judge. That's why I wanted to apply it with you. I actually like this color in me. So this is the thing, it applied very easily and is applying very, very thin layer, which I really like. It's not really covering my reds. And that usually happens with most of the foundations at the beginning. They actually irritate my skin, so it looks red at the beginning. But then once the redness comes down a little bit, it kind of goes away. So I'm not so concerned if it doesn't completely cover it at the beginning. But let's see. Maybe it's, just made a mess. Whoops, 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 whoops. All right, well. The good news is that it's so light, liquidy, and it looks like it's totally just soaking it in my skin. So that is a good thing. So I was telling you a little bit of what I had on. So if you've been following me, I've been trying the Victoria Beckham Cell Rejuvenation. I'm actually on purpose leaving the amount that I did so it soaks in and covers more, right? So I'm using the Victoria Beckham Cell Rejuvenation Regimen, which is the serum, and then the primer moisturizing and protector. I think she calls like all of it at once. I miss some of my moisturizer cream because I feel that it doesn't moisture my skin enough. Probably if I had just a tiny bit of combination skin, it would be perfect because it mattifies. I spoke about that. But I've been allowing it to do its thing because I want to see in the long run if it really makes a difference in my skin. I've been wearing it for over 10 days now. It's not maybe enough, but, and I'm not sure. I'm not sure I have seen a difference, and I'm not sure I've seen any plumping, and I'm not sure I've seen any blurring, and I miss my moisturizer. So it doesn't talk too well about it. But I don't want to discourage just yet. We're going to give it a fair trial. So, okay, here it is what happens. And this happens to me, not my sister. So there's a lot of people that love this foundation. I don't know if you can see, but you can see my pores and then the actual foundation in it. I don't know if it's dry patches. You see there? It didn't really cover my little stains. I actually think it emphasized them. How can that be possible? I don't know. There's some stuff that does that. And I can see, like, it's almost like if I had put powder on. You see here? It's very, very, maybe you can't. It's just, and it looks like it's on top of my skin. It doesn't look like it completely got in. And it's not that I put too much, because I put too much here and it's not doing that. It's just in some areas. You can say it looks like dry patches. You see here? But it's not like dry patches. It looks more like it emphasizes my pores, and I don't even have big, large pores. So there you have it. This is the foundation. I mean, would it work? I guess so. Do I like it? No, not really for me. But again, it's my sister's favorite. So why am I scratching all over? It's just when I don't like it. But yeah, I don't think it does anything for me. It doesn't cover my red. It, It emphasizes, I can see the foundation in the cracks of my wrinkles. Like in there, you see that? Yeah, you can't see it, of course. I see it. I see it on the camera. So look at that. It's almost like if it's filling up the wrinkles, but it looks powdery in the middle. And look, where I touch, it just, yeah, guys, I'm sorry. I know so this is some people's favorite. Of course, my sister is 26, 27 now, I think. She has perfect skin, no wrinkles, no nothing, and it really luminizes and looks beautiful. But my age or my skin, I don't know, not good. So the question now is if I continue with the rest of my makeup or I change the foundation and do a different look. Look, let's finish it off since I started. I'm going to use my Filmstar Bronze Glow just because we're gonna do this Charlotte Tilbury quad. And then I'm gonna put a little bit of the illuminating powder. Right? I'm just trying to kind of use it a little bit as a setting powder, I guess. If... yeah, wow. The difference that a foundation can do. All right, well, we're gonna do a quick one here, guys, because I'm not even sure I should show you this. I mean, what kind of a review it is when you're just gonna not say the most nicest thing, but I guess you need to hear it. I mean, that's what a review is, right? Because I also have the Givenchy foundation that I wanna try. I also have a sample of that one. I'll do another video with that one. So here it is. I'm using the Cheek to Cheek Sex on Fire because I just want a light sort of blush. And I also actually want to put it on because I don't like being with all pale on camera. But there you have it. So let's do the eye look. First, let me put a little bit of a lip liner. I'm gonna put a little bit of the Super Size Me. It's one of my favorites for a more nuded sort of lips. So we're gonna do that. Yep. Wow, well, this has a lot of color. I did not remember it having so much color. Maybe I used, of course I have the Pillow Talk. And they have the other one that is also the Pillow Talk and the, there's another one that is a lot nuder. No, I have two Super Size Me. Well, I guess I'm too bare and now it's like color, but I do like it. It brings it a little color. And since I'm gonna use this lipstick, which is very nude, let's put it on. That way I'm starting to get some color. So, this is one of my favorites from Charlotte Tilbury at the beginning for nude lips. You know, she had a bestseller on Pillow Talk. I just spoke about that full collection in my last two videos. If you want, check them out. I'll list it below. But because Pillow Talk was too nude for me or didn't do much, you'll see in the videos I use a gloss on top of it and then I really, really like it. But I was not that knowledgeable, not that I am now, but a little more before. So I just thought the lipstick itself, it didn't work. Actually, she hadn't come up with these pump pillow, I mean glosses that I actually now use and works. And all right, anyhow. So the nude color that did work for me was this one, which is Bitch Perfect. This one has a little more peach in it. Let me see, I'll make the comparison between the Pillow Talk, the Bitch Perfect, and then another nude favorite, which is the, not a model that strong. I think it's JK Magic. Is it? Let's see here. Yeah, JK Magic. So I'll swatch it here for you. So here, that's JK Magic. And then these are kind of the nudes. I'll show you all together. So that's JK Magic, and then this is Pillow Talk. And I remember when it first came out and I was checking them out online. On camera, look, they look like they really have color for you, right? Like they really are gonna show up. But it just happens that it's almost my lip color. And this is Pitch Perfect. So very little difference here, right? This is JK Magic. No, I mean, this is Pillow Talk. JK Magic, Pillow Talk, and the Pitch Perfect. I mean, wow, you barely can see a difference. And yet, this one is the one that looks good on me. So, I mean, if you're buying online, it's, you know, why, right? I mean, maybe it's the lighting, maybe. Yeah, very little difference. So this is the Pitch Perfect. This is Pillow Talk in the middle, and that's JK Magic. So let me put it on. You see? You see? My lips have a little more pink in it, and these are peachier. But for some reason, this one works better when I'm using a very bare bottom. And it's not that bare, really, because you saw the lip liner gave me color, and now this gives me color. I guess I prefer that way, that if I'm totally nuded out, maybe because of the yellow undertone in my skin, that it just doesn't work. Anywho. So now I don't feel so bare, but let's get to the feature. Aww. And also we are looking at how the foundation is performing through time. I'm actually liking it better now that it's setting, even though I didn't use setting powder. I can put some setting powder and see what happens, but I feel my skin looks dry already. You know, I have recommended to you guys, and I really like it, this Bobbi Brown Illuminating Moisture Balm. I actually have the full size, but I have it in my bathroom. This one is sort of a primer illuminating glowy thing, but not glow. It's just a very healthy. I'm really liking that. I didn't use it today because, one, I want to try the foundations with nothing before it, so they're all consistent. But and also, I am using the Victoria Beckham, like I mentioned. So I want to see how it's supposed to be used just by itself. But no, I will put a little more moisture, and I probably will use this. I really like this. I used to use the Laura Mercier Illuminating Primer before. That was my to-go, just to give that little healthy look. But now this Bobbi Brown is my favorite. So just FYI. And just to break it down a little bit, sorry, so many interruptions, but I have the Aqua Allegoria Mandarin Basilic from Guerlain. I think I mentioned this in other videos. This is a very mandarin kind of fragrance. I'm putting on some because it just refreshes, activates, puts you in a great mood, optimism. I don't know, I just love it. And so it could be a good lift me up in the middle of the video. All right, so let's continue. I had a teacher that we were working on Zoom, and he's like, so funny how you utilize things, senses, in order to kind of motivate you, lift you, or, you know, put you in a different mood. And I do. That's why I love having so many fragrances, because it just, you know, gives something to the ambience, to the feeling, to the senses. Anywho, here I am rambling, and not getting to what I need to do. All right, so beautiful palette, beautiful. Ah, She has another palette, which are grayish. She has more spark. And again, it's one of those palettes that they just look gray, right? And you think, oh, gray is gray. But they apply very different according to your skin tones. And the other palette did not work that well on me. It actually looked like an Apache eye. You know, an Apache eye, it just looked like I became punched in the face or something. Oh my God, that sounds horrible. Well, it's just the perfume. It's not me. So I hope if you hire my coloring, this is helpful to you, because I know it was for me and it is for me watching other YouTubers and looking for my undertone. And then, you know, what I have done is when one of the YouTubers likes something and it really works for them, and if I buy it and it doesn't work for me, then I know that we are not in the undertones. And then, you know, when it works for them, I kind of know it's a little tuned down or a little tuned up or whatever. Browner works for them versus rosary. Or, I mean, things like that. You start figuring out. It's interesting how that works. All right. So the first thing, as you know, I always go for the lightest shade. And if you remember my reviews on Charlotte Tilbury, I say that she makes it very easy. She always says, like, the number one, use all over the lid. And then two is in the crease or in the outer corner. And then three, you can smoke it out or enhance. And then four is the pop of color in the middle of the lid. She usually organizes her palettes that way. So it makes it very easy for us that are not makeup artists or that we don't necessarily know what we're doing. So the interesting part now that I'm looking at my lid, you know how I place a little bit of that high illuminating powder from the film, this one, how I placed it a little bit kind of setting on top of my lids. What I'm noticing now, which is gorgeous as I apply this, is that there is some golden illumination in my lid. Look at that. When I first apply it, I kind of didn't notice really, but look at that. You see some color? That is from that illuminating powder. I just want to point out how beautiful that is. And you know, I do like the coloring of the foundation. So let's start. I mean, after how much I said negative things about it at the beginning, let's at least say the positive things about it, right? I'm glad I didn't take it off, because that way we can really see how it performs and how it sets and how it lays on the skin. And so far, I love that first color. What do you guys think? Then I'm gonna put the second, which is supposed to be crease or outer corner. And I'm using the Wayne Goss number 420. You know, these are one of my favorites. They're awesome for hooded eyes, for small real estate like I do, because they're fluffy enough, but they're small. Most of my other brushes are much bigger, and so I find that I have to be very careful. The other brushes that I really like to apply makeup with, but they are not natural hair, they're synthetic, but they work awesome, and I do use it for the brand, is the Natasha Denona. And Natasha Denona, I know sometimes, I didn't buy it like that, I wish I did, but sometimes they run these sales or these specials on the whole bundle of all her brush sets. Well, maybe not all, but like the most important, I think it's like $190, but it goes down, it comes with a cylinder with all the brushes. I really recommend that, because all her brushes are useful, and they're useful for different parts of the makeup, applying makeup process. And I do find that they all are very, very useful, especially if you own some Natasha Denona eyeshadows or makeup. I don't own a lot of her face, you know, foundation and things like that, but her eyeshadows and blushes and things like that, and they really work well together. I'm actually gonna do like a 10-day Natasha Denona, because I wanna use her palettes. I don't use them that much. And I bought them just because I love the coloring. So here I am rambling and having fun applying the the eyeshadow. But look how beautiful. This is just two. And it has a lot of illuminating, not shiny, but you know, the quality of Charlotte Tilbury when it comes to mature, elegant makeup is there. And look at that. If I just use the liquid eyeliner there, I would really love it. But of course, let's finish the look a little bit to use the whole palette. So I'm gonna use the third color, this one, just lightly. Let's enhance, like she usually says that their eyeshadow does, enhance. And I want you to notice how my mood changes as I'm using a product that I actually like. I don't know if you noticed I was rambling and going on and saying all this about the foundation, and it's kind of like I speed up and it's not really enjoying the process. But when it's something I really enjoy and like, it's like, ooh, I can spend so much time. Look at that. Beautiful, right? And I'm not doing the other eye because I don't want to take your time. I will do it off camera. So I'm going to the enhance and I am applying it. I'll tell you which brush I'm using right now, Sonia G. But oh my God, this is, I love this eyeshadow. Look at that. Yep. So what I'm doing is what I usually do, a little up diagonally and then in. I am bringing it up a little bit just so when I open my eye, you can see a little bit of the enhanced color, just because I have my hooded eyes and this is so drop that I have to do that. If not, you know, when I open my eyes like this, you wouldn't see the crease at all because it's right here and it gets all covered. But if I bring it up a little bit and just a little bit, never all the way to my eyebrow. Sometimes you can bring it up like this here, so that way you really covers all this. Beautiful. And last but not least, let's use the pop. That's the pop color. And usually I use my finger to it. Oh yeah. You can put it on the brush, but I keep hearing that it's much more noticeable if you do it with your finger. Yep, I'm gonna put a little bit of a little bit more of the brighter, which is the number one, just in the outer corner and in the middle here and the bottom. Yep. I'm almost tempted to bring it all the way. Yeah, no, I would prefer it just in the middle. And then of course, the outer. I would put some of the medium color just because the medium color seems that it has more shine. The enhanced color, this one is very, not totally matte, but very matte, a little more. It's perfect name, enhance, right? It just, you see that? It doesn't bring all the shine or illuminating like the other two. Oh my God, but this is so lovely. And the next video I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use the Chanel quad. I don't think I have it right here. The one that is all gray. Let's see if it's here. Because I want you to see the difference. It's very different because the Chanel one, they're a little less illuminating. I'm trying to see if I have it up here. If not, just check out the channel and I'll do the comparison on that one. Apologize for that. Yeah, it's not here. I need to look at it in the other. Well, hold on, I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back. So the other quad of Chanel is this one. It is gray, but it has a little green in it, you see? Now let me right? So I'll do some swatches on the other video if you want to check it out to compare. That way I can finish this look now that I've taken so much of your time and then I preview the foundation. So I'm going to go and finish my other eye, include the liquid eyeliner, and I'll be right back. Hello, so I am back. This is the final look. So I added the liquid eyeliner. It's the color Panther. I must say, this is very interesting because liquid eyeliners, you could say that they're all very similar. They're all the same, right? I mean, it's just a little pencil or a little brush thing wet that you line up with. But I'm impressed of how many variances they are. You know, each applicator works different. Each consistency works different. And in the final look, it's very minute. I mean, if you're not a makeup artist, makeup expert, probably you can't tell. But those minute things, I think, is what makes a difference in a final look, which is very interesting. So what do I think of this liquid liner Panther? Which, first thing, I love this part. You know how it's like you grab it there. I don't necessarily grab it there to apply it, but I like how that looks. And of course, I love the look and feel of Charlotte Tilbury makeup. You know, it's all like, it seems plastic. Well, it is plastic, but it has a little luxury to it. It doesn't feel so light and you know, of course it's expensive, it's luxury makeup. But at the same time, it looks very practical. Look how thin, look how small. And everything seems very cohesive, organized. I mean, and everything is practical, it's usable. I mean, you see the blushes, it has the two colors already in it. You know, the quads are very organized on 1, 2, 3, 4. All the liquid or lip liners or things like that, you know, very, you know, this is very helpful, the color. So when you have them, you can see the different colors, although it's not that easy to recognize which is which. But you know, you can see the lightest, the pinkish, the peaches. So it's very well thought brand. There's this other lipstick and everything on the golden rose sort of theme, gold rose, golden rose, you know. For some people like myself, it's a little, not everything works because of that goldenness or that rose. It's not necessarily my best. However, she does have, like today, and like items like this, you know, vary for the cooler tones or the yellowish tones like myself. So I love the brand. You know this. I've done many videos on it and I'm going to continue because I still have many to go. But on this actual look, so the liquid eyeliner, just to finalize that, I went on a tangent. I like it. It's very beautiful. This is more glowy liquid, kind of in your face, Panther black, right? But I enjoy still my Rare Beauty matte liquid eyeliner for a more natural. I guess this is more up and go. If I wanted to make this an eye look, you saw before I added the pop of color. And oh, I haven't added the pop of color on the left side. I don't even know if you are aware of it. Can you tell? Can you tell? Wow. Oh yeah, you can tell. So I hadn't applied this. Let me apply it here. And the other thing I wanted to do here with you is my dog wants to come in. We're about to be finished so I can get up and get him. I'm gonna apply a little bit of this Portofino. I should use the Pillow Talk. No, let's use the Pillow Talk. You see Portofino is a little pinkish. This is more nude. This is Pillow Talk, this is Portofino. But since we put the peachy, I don't wanna put the pinky. It will work, really doesn't matter. But yes. All right, guys, this is the final look. Love the eyeshadow quad. Like the liquid liner. Of course, the lipstick I love. A little bit of blush. Love, obviously, this. I've talked about it so many times. And so there you have it. Thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you next. Oh, this is the time. Remind you to please subscribe to my channel. please touch the bell to know when I upload new videos. Please request, suggest, comment. Let's keep the conversation going. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.